Hi friends, I am Manmad Krishna. You are watching Manmad Krishna Food Tech channel. Now today our topic is naturally occurring chemicals part 2. Those who have not watched my video part 1, I have given the link below. Please watch that. Thank you. Histamine fish poisoning. So histamine fish poisoning, especially the fishes, most of the fishes, more number of fishes, the fish plus which contains certain kinds of amino acids which is called histidine. The fish flesh contains histidine. Scombroid species. The scombroid species, most of the scombroids, the fish flesh contains more quantity of amino acids like histidine amino acids. What will happen? Whenever the temperature increases will occur, whenever the time and temperature increases, the histidine protein, histidine amino acid will turn to histamine by the action of enzymatic activity, by the action of histidine decarboxylating, histamine decarboxylating enzyme activity. How these enzymes will activate on this histidine protein? Certain kinds of enzymes which are produced by certain kinds of bacteria which are invading in the gut region of fishes. Many fishes like mackerel, tuna, a skipjack, marlin, mahi-mahi, etc. So tunas, mackerels, skipjack tuna, yellowfin tuna, blue marlin and sailfish, swordfish, mahi-mahi, cold water fishes. These fishes plus contains the amino acid which is called histidine amino acid. The histidine amino acid, what will happen? The fishes, during the fishes in live condition, the bacteria which are presenting in gill region and surface of the fish and inside the gut region, which cannot penetrate into the deeper part of the meat and which cannot release the enzymes and which cannot act on the fish flesh, which cannot convert the histidine into histamine due to the fish natural defense mechanism. So these are the fishes mostly harvested by the mechanism, the crafts and guides are using long lining. The fishes can be harvested by long lining or gill netting. Long lining is a long process. So several hooks, they will tag into a big rope and they will put the bait on the hooks and they will put that long lining. This will take many hours, and gill netting also. What will happen? Generally the fish body temperature in the water, sea water, 22 degrees centigrade. Water temperature, sea water temperature might be 22 degrees centigrade. The surface may be 22 or sometimes 25 degrees centigrade will be there. But then the fish flesh also 22 degrees centigrade temperature, 18 to 22 degrees centigrade. Fishes like tuna and skipjack, the temperature inside the fish is plus 18 to plus 22. So what will happen? When the harvesting will take place, they will do the long lining. So long lining means several hooks they will tag in a rope and they will put the bait. After several hours only they will pull out the rope. So what will happen? Once the tuna or any scombroid fishes will eat the bait, will trap by the hooks, it will struggle before death. What happened? If the fish struggles before death, for hour or 30 minutes or 1 hour, struggling before death, what will happen? Once the fish is struggling to escape from the bait, automatically the body temperature will increase. So these 22 degrees centigrade, the fish caught in the hook and struggling for death, what will happen? Before death, the temperature reaches to 32 degrees centigrade. As per the experimental studies and Japanese scientists proved this, 32 degrees centigrade also will attain. So before death, the fish temperature will reaches to 32 degrees centigrade inside the fish. After death, what will happen? At that temperature, the bacteria which are presenting in the gills, which are presenting in the surface of the skin, which are presenting in the gut region, 32 degrees centigrade is very favorable temperature for the bacterial growth, for the enzymatic activity. What will happen? The bacteria which are invading in the gut region of the scombroid fishes, the flora which is invading in the gut region will penetrate into the deeper part of the meat. The bacteria will penetrate into the deeper part of the meat because of this temperature is very favorable for the bacteria. If the tunas or any scombroids, plus 21 degrees centigrade, according to scientific study, plus 21 degrees centigrade, tell us the histamine levels will produce 200 ppm. Whereas, plus 32 degrees centigrade, unacceptable levels of histamine will produce in 6 hours. Might be, after harvesting the fishes, put on the duck, might be, the levels might be exceeded. Because of the fish might have died several hours before harvest, before taking into the deck. The scombroid fishes, gut contains so microbial flora. So microbial flora, what happens after death? Soon after death of the fish defense mechanism will lost. The bacteria which are invading in the gill region, the bacteria which are invading in the gut region can penetrate into the deeper part of the meat, and the bacteria will release certain kinds of enzymes during the growth. So these are the many bacteria, decarboxylizing bacteria. For example, Pseudomonas and Enterococcus, etc. Clostridium. Most of the bacteria are facultative anaerobic bacteria, which are enteric bacteria, which are invading in the fish gut region. After death of the fish, will enter into the deeper part of the meat, and by the action of enzymatic activity, these bacteria will produce decarboxylase, acidine decarboxylase enzyme. These bacteria during growth will produce decarboxylizing enzyme. What will happen? The histidine, by the enzymatic activity, decarboxylizing activity of bacteria, the histidine turns into histamine. Histamine is a poison. Histidine is a amino acid. Histamine is a benefit. Histamine is a toxin. The histamine toxin cannot be eliminated by cooking also. So the precautionary measures, what we have to do. So the harvesting should be the short period, and the long laying also we have to make ensure. And after harvest or soon after death of the fish, we have to gilled and gutted the fish and put it in the ice slurries, making the temperature plus 4 degrees centigrade or below, making ice slurries or making a refrigeration temperature. Circulate the slurries. We have to maintain the chill temperature after harvest or after death of the fish. We can minimize the growth of histamine formation. We can minimize the growth of enzymatic bacteria which are producing enzymes. And let us discuss about the one more thing. The bacteria before freezing, the freezing will arrest the growth of enzymes. But what will happen after harvest? You made the fish gilled and gutted, but the bacteria after harvest, after death, the bacteria proliferated and emitted decarboxylizing enzymes. But even after inactivate the bacteria, the enzymes will start action on the flesh. If we can inactivate the bacteria, the enzyme action will start. It won't stop. If you can freeze the fish, the enzyme activity will stop. The enzyme activity will be arrested. Once you thaw the fish for reprocess, what will happen? If the PC is in inactivate stage, if the bacteria is in inactivate stage after thawing, once the PC is frozen, after thawing the bacteria, even if it is inactivated stage, the bacteria, the enzymes will start reactivating once the favorable temperature attains. So the thawing scombroid fishes also, if enzymes are present inside the flesh, will develop histamine, will produce the toxins higher levels during the processing, during the reprocessing. We must be very cautious. How to prevent the histamine formation in fish flesh, especially in the scombroid fishes? The time and temperature control. This is the preventive measure. After harvest, the fish must be rapid chilled. The fish must be gilled and gutted. And temperature, we have to drop the temperature, or we have to put the fish in ice slurry which maintains 4 degrees centigrade or below. And the rapid processing period. So the processing period also, we have to maintain cold chain system. These are the methods to prevent the histamine formation, higher levels of histamine formation. This time and temperature abuse, we have to minimize, we have to take the precautions about the lengthy time period and temperature also. After harvest, the fish must be eviscerated, the fish must be gilled, the fish must be chilled. And the processing period also, we have to maintain rapid processing period. And cold chain, we have to maintain. So, we can injure the fish which is below the level. And we have to test the histamine levels also in the different portions of the fish flesh. So, this is how we can prevent the histamine formation in fish product. Symptoms of histamine poisoning. So, what will happen? So, when the person is ingested with histamine producing fish, what will happen? Mouth, the symptoms in the mouth. So the burning sensation in the mouth and tingling sensation, both upper and lower jaws, tingling sensation and burning sensation in the mouth. And the gut, when you take to the gut, you feel like vomiting will come and diarrhea also will occur. Sometimes abdominal cramps also will occur, the symptoms. And once we come to the skin, skin, what will happen? The upper portion of the skin rashes will occur. And the skin hives also will occur. Itching sensation also will occur. Air. So, wheezing sound. Difficulty in breathing. So, when you inhale, you will get some wheezing sound or difficulty in breathing. And cardio, what will happen? The lower the BP. So, blood pressure will come down. These symptoms, these allergy symptoms will appear in human beings after eating the histamine producing fish after 30 minutes of eating to maximum 2 hours. So the toxins above 50 ppm as per USFDA guidelines, 50 ppm. So the fish should be less than 50 ppm is advisable to eat. If the fish is above 50 ppm, it will cause illness. Most of the illnesses occur above 200 ppm histamine in fish flesh. Thank you. If you like my videos, please subscribe my videos and click the bell icon to get the regular updates and share it to your friend circle.